Okay, so it's been a quiet night last night. So I've been a bit quiet. It's pretty early in the morning. It's just after 5:30. Got a beautiful sunrise. Yeah, very quiet. I didn't see anything last night. Got it fairly late. Had two laps. Absolutely nothing. The weight goes on probably for another 800 yards to my left, and probably about the same to my right. It's about 16 acres, I think. It's like it's not a particularly hard lake. It's got about 150 fish in it, but it's my first time back on the lake in about 5 years, so just kind of fish to the similar spots I used to fish to. Anyway, the key thing I want to talk to you about is about rigs. I'm fishing tonight in a massively snaggy area. If I can get into the swim, I'm pretty sure we'll be able to, but it's massively snaggy. I mean, it's hit and hold to the 8th degree. I mean, I'm fishing locked up tight. I'm sleeping right next to my rods. And the rod is literally, the rod butt is sat literally on the side of the bed chair, so I can get it, hit it, roll out, and sort of play the fish. You know, we're playing for 40 pounders, you know, potentially in some very snaggy situations, which, provided you've got really strong tackle, provided you're locked up, provided you're right on your rods, I've landed them pretty successfully, I've got to say. That's not meant to sound bullshit, it's just meant to say that if you use the right stuff, you don't piss about away from your rods, you've got a very good chance of landing them. Just have a look at the rig that I'm going to be using. Let's start down there. So, 45 pound lead core leader that I've just camoed up. Down to a 4 ounce inline lead. And I'm using the quarter ones. And then from here, pretty basic stuff really. But I keep the coating on for a good section of my hook length when it's going in a PVA bag, I should say. Okay, and the reason being is that I want that inherent stiffness. The problem is once you've got PVA bag and satin bottom, and you've got a really incredibly soft hook length, because obviously either you've peeled back all the outer coating, or you've just got like a dedicated braided hook length, then whilst it's great you can fold it all up and put it in the bag and everything, the reality is that unless you're using a weighted pop-up, which I don't use, I use nearly all the time straight bottom baits or wafters for this style of fishing. And I mean like really heavily soap wash wafters, that they just sink. It doesn't reset very well. Can't even land like horrendous. And I've tested it in the margin over and again, and just wasn't happy that if I got done, it wouldn't reset for the next fish. By only having this amount of section done, I can fold that up into the bag really easily. So if I just put that over like that, that will easily go into the bag, no problem at all. I use big bags and pull them out, so I'm not casting long distance. So again, these can fold over in the long sort of fox bags that I use about that sort of long. So it's no issue there whatsoever. But my point is, as you're going to imagine, hello guys. They've been fed all morning. Bless them, super cute. Although not cute when they legged it through the right hand rod about 15 minutes ago. It will reset nice and easily and come to rest. Now, I used to use the flip and turn with a bit of silicone at the top. And I used to use, obviously, shrink tube, but where I am at the moment, I haven't got kettle with me, so I haven't really liked it. I've literally slipped under the stars last night. It's got my bag, bed chair, mats under the bed chair, and net, and the rods, and that's it. If I can't carry it, it doesn't come so many sessions. Anyway, I digress, but now I'd rather that the hook drops down each and every time. As soon as they pick that bait out, boom, it's prone. It doesn't have to flip. It's one less thing for it to do. It will literally just drop. It doesn't have to go over anything to drop. It will just do it naturally. And obviously with the fact that it's going to reset, it's a pretty solid rig. And of course, I push this in quite hard. And there's a reason for that, because you've got to imagine that I'm under a bush and I want them as low in the water as possible. So when they jerk their head back and forth trying to get under the hook, they will most likely dislodge the majority of the way on this, and I'll test it again in the margins. Sometimes they'll get rid of it completely, sometimes they will get halfway. But either way, they'll dislodge it a hell of a lot, and it'll keep them low until I can get them out, and sometimes get the lead back. Sometimes later in the fight it'll come off, but it gives me a kind of little bit of a leeway under there to sort of have enough weight to keep them low in the water so they don't come up under the snag and start hitting all the snaggy bushes that are hanging into the water. Anyway, that's a quick look at my snag reel. It is pretty basic, I've got to admit. I mean, I'm a bit sort of, sometimes do admit I do use Fandango rigs, but they always look neat and pretty, and this one's pretty basic, to be fair. But it works, and it works very, very well. So yeah, that's my snag rig. That'll go in a PVO bag. What I tend to do is crush some pellets, crush some boilies, tons of liquid in there. More liquid than anything else. I don't want a lot of food items in there. I want some crushed dark boilie, crushed pellet, and then I use a trimmed wafter in there that sort of emulates a pellet. And I'll trim it down and soak it. So it's a super heavy wafter. And then yeah, that's it. I'll pole it out under the bush. I mean, to be honest, just to give an example, this isn't the lake I'm talking about, but I will literally have my bed chair Kevin Mannix style right next to the rod, so I can literally roll over, play it, and because my bag isn't zipped up, I can just basically swing my legs out and start playing the fish. But the snags are probably equivalent of one rod length to the right, so it's like this huge overhanging bush, and it's like a cave canopy that goes in sort of thing. So I've written on my hand, God knows what that was, so it works thing. But basically, yeah, I'll pole it in, and right deep into the snag. And I will not touch that for 48 hours if necessary. I will just leave it, because the fish did patrol through there and I saw an absolute chunk. Little common, little mirror next to it, and it softened the way. Always get a couple of smaller tag on fish, but it was a good fish. I don't think it was the big one in there. I'd say it was a mid 40, but it was a chunky fish. Listen, I've waffled on, guys. I'm really sorry. I hope you have a lovely day. Enjoy your fishing. And I know I've been doing a lot of sort of short, fairly rubbishy little videos, and which isn't ideal considering I work in digital imaging. It's just I've been fairly lazy with a phone doing the video. But what I will do is I'll start to put together a proper like diary piece, and you know, do proper footage, and look a lot better than what I've been doing. So anyway, enjoy your day, guys, and catch up later. Tight lines.